When evaluating a display's performance or calibrating a display's color management system, or CMS, this is the page you use. The first thing I do is I look at the CIE 1931 chart, and I look at the primary and secondary colors to see which one is having issues. Looking at this chart, I see that the cyan color is having the most issues. The round dot is the measured value. The square is the target where it should line up. To activate a given color, like cyan, simply navigate to the slider control and activate the cyan color. This will pull up all the data for the color. The hue error for cyan shows the amount of error in relationship to this pathway. If the cyan had green error, it would be moving towards green. A hue error towards blue would be moving towards blue. And that is the relationship between the movement of this chart. And I can clearly see that I have a negative hue error, which for this activated color is towards green. The saturation chart shows the relationship of the activated color with relationship to white. If it's oversaturated, the color starts moving outside the standard. If it's undersaturated, it's more towards white on this pathway. And again, I can see that I have a positive saturation error, which means that I'm oversaturated and I'm outside the standard. The luminance error is a little tricky since the CIE chart that we're using to evaluate these primary and secondary colors doesn't have a z-axis. It's not a three-dimensional chart. You simply rely on this luminance error chart alone. But if you did have a three-dimensional chart, this would essentially be the z-axis of a given primary or secondary color. If you'd like to evaluate another color, a different primary or secondary, you would simply select it along the slider control and evaluate the same hue, saturation, and luminance charts. We hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching.